The work that I do, for the most part now, is teaching people how to hum the sounds that are good for their bodies. And it's really all about using your voice to move energy through your body, to feel your voice vibrating someplace in your body. And then as you move it and change the pitch, feel the energy moving in your body. It's a whole relationship that if you start to develop, it's wonderful because you have this another depth to the relationship. You have this, if you start to work with your chakras and you've been imagining them, you know, all of your life, and people who can see, you know, that's great. People like me who can't see, I hear, you know, and I get this black screen when someone says, now imagine this. No, I'm not going to see anything. I know it's going to be a black screen of nothing. And it just kind of frustrates me. But for those of us who are listeners, as opposed to seers, that's listening is just a whole lot easier. The vocal range of our voices determines the musical key of our body. We all have, our bodies respond to a certain key, and that musical key is based on the range of our voices, because we are made so that within our vocal range, we can hum sounds that redirect energy in our body and help us to heal ourselves. It's just how we're made, right? So being able to do that, being able, if you had been imagining your chakras for years like me and not seeing anything and thinking, oh, this is all a bunch of woo-woo, these things don't exist because I have no proof whatsoever. I can't see them, I can't feel them, I can't smell them, I can't touch them. What are these chakras, right? Until I decided if it was real, I should be able to hum a note that it would make me feel it in my body, and then I would believe that it was real. So that's when I started humming around, because I play with sound, right? And I hummed the lowest note I could comfortably hum, and I could feel my root chakra vibrating. And I was like, whoa, these things are real. They do exist. And then I figured out the scale. So you start with that root chakra note that is determined by how low your voice goes comfortably. And then there's a predictable scale. It's a Lydian scale. It's not a major scale. There's one, you know, when you look at chakra charts and you read about the sounds of the chakras, you always see a C major scale. And that will work for somebody. It'll work for some people whose lowest note they can sing is C. That will work for them. But there's a whole lot of people that won't work for. The major scale part of it, it's only off by a half step of one note. So I think this is just stuff that's been lost in translation over thousands and thousands of years. So we have this chakra chart of the C major scale, and it's a clue. You know, it's a piece of it, but it's not the whole thing. So the scale is a Lydian scale. So a major scale is do, re, mi, fa, sol, right? The Lydian scale, do, re, mi, fi, sol. It's just one note difference. But if you try to use that do for your root chakra, re for your sacral chakra, mi for your solar plexus, fa, you won't feel your heart chakra vibrating if you sing hum fa. You got to hum a half step higher, fi, and then you'll feel it. Sol, la, ti. So I figured out everyone has a different starting note, but all of those scales are the same once you find the starting note. And that's pretty exciting, because when you start humming your chakras and you feel them vibrate, I mean, you're bringing circulation, you're bringing oxygenation to that area of the body, and you're raising the energy of that gland that is connected to that chakra. And those glands are turning systems on and off in your body all the time, emotions, fight or flight. I mean, there's way to really balance. You know, solar plexus has to do with the pancreas gland and the, so your blood sugar, right? Your throat chakra is your thyroid gland. This is pituitary gland and the pineal gland, and they all do all these things. So when you're vibrating them, you're like saying to the brain, hello, Hello, a knock knock on the door, you know, I'm interested in you. And after you do it for a while, you start to have this a whole different relationship with your body. And you get to feel like you have some control over your health. Because you can, if this note here for your throat chakra is F, and this note here is G, and all this, and you've got a really clogged sinuses, well, your sinuses live in between these two chakras. The note between F and G is F sharp. F sharp is going to vibrate this part of your body, and you're going to be able to, you know, drain your sinuses. So knowing your chakra notes gives you access to vibrate all these different parts of your body and send energy to them. So that was the first big class that we did. And then I went one step deeper, because sometimes just humming that chakra isn't enough to really set it straight again, to get it reharmonized, because there's something old and ancient that's stuck in there. That's keeping it from really, there's old cellular memory, and maybe there's pain associated with that old cellular memory. It's a pain that you've had forever, and you do many things to try to fix it, and it gets fixed for a while, then it comes back. So you can't fix a physical problem that started on an emotional plane. And so when you learn how to hum your chakras, usually just humming them resets them, but sometimes it doesn't, and you have to go deeper. And that's when I found harmonics are the answers to going into all the different energetic planes. So we have a chart of these sort of different energetic, you know, harmonic layers. And I have a chart of all of the notes of the chakra scales, of the harmonics of the chakra scales. I've created these chimed harmonic scales, so we can hum along with them. This is telling you, if you know what your root chakra note is, or if you know what any chakra note is, these are the first eight harmonics, and how these harmonics correlate to the different sections, the different anatomy, if you will, of our auric field. So the chakra note that's closest to the body there would be on the bottom in the orange line. And when you hum that, you know, you're feeling the physical body vibrate, the cells of the physical body and the etheric body, just a little bit, couple inches out from your body. And then when you move up to the next harmonic, that third harmonic, your energy expands out a little bit farther into your emotional body. And we hum that for five times, and then the next harmonic goes to the mental body. The next harmonic vibrates the astral body, then it vibrates the etheric body, the celestial body, the etheric body. So now you're out at the edge of your auric field, right? So we're working really with the first eight harmonics that I've recorded for everyone to hum along with. I think of harmonics as full spectrum sound, right? Full spectrum light contains all the colors of the rainbow and the light spectrum, but at full spectrum sound is a sound that is rich in harmonics. So what are harmonics? When one note is played and sustained, depending on the resonance of the room, the sound expands. And as it expands, the sound gets fuller, right? Harmonics are, let's call the brother and sister tones that sound along with that main note because they're mathematically related. It's a phenomenon called, physics of sound is called the harmonic series of notes. It's how sound naturally expands. And the more harmonics that are sounding, and the bigger and fuller is the sound, right? So discovering that these harmonics expand and the sound expands the same way our auric field expands was a really big discovery for me. And knowing that that we can vibrate all of these different aspects of the emotional body, and the spiritual body and the mental body, and it just clears things out. I made a mistake when I first started working with this, because I went to the a recording studio and I recorded all of these harmonics. And then I got the email with all of them back for me to test. And I was like, okay, I'm going to take all of my notes. And when I go to sleep tonight, I'm going to put this MP3 on and I'm just going to listen to it. Mostly I was listening for the quality of the sound to make sure, you know, it was going to be pleasing to the ear. And I kind of fell asleep. I woke up the next morning. Oh, I was in such a funk. I had listened to the first 16 harmonics of all of my chakras before I went to sleep. And I woke up, I was depressed. I was heavy. I was having suicidal thoughts. This was not me. And I was, what? And it took me a couple of hours to remember. Yeah. I listened to all of the harmonics of all of my chakras last night before I went to sleep. And I woke up in a mess emotionally, because so much had been brought up, it was all unconscious, but it had released so much stuff from the auric field that I really had to listen to my chakra sounds again and get myself back grounded and centered. And just, I had a cry. Just let the feelings go through you. Don't think there's anything wrong with you. If you feel like you need to have a cry, have a cry. You just release it. You're just letting go of it. So this work is really how you get deep, deep, deep into the chakras in a way that you can feel it and experience it in a tangible way, which is so hard for me. If someone just does a guided meditation, I just can't follow it. But when I have a sound to hold on to and connect with, it just makes it so much more real.